Hello student, I am Balwant Makwana. I am taking your subject called Microengineering and this is the first lecture. In this lecture, we will do the introduction to the microengineering. So, this subject is taken by myself and Namratam. I will take half of the session and the rest of the part will be done by Namratam. So, in my person, I will teach you introduction to micro, then I will take transmission line equation, all the solutions in the transmission line. Thereafter I will take the component, specifically I will do a magnetron, then klystron, DWDA and all other things. So we'll start with the introduction to microwave engineering. So first question arises, what does this microwave? This is the outline of my presentation. First is, we will see that what is the microwave and in the electromagnetic spectrum where it will lies and what are its advantage, disadvantage and various applications. So we will start with the term microwave. What does microwave mean? So microwave actually stands for, micro means a very small or a tiny thing. So in a wave we are having either amplitude or we are having a frequency, or in other terms we can say all the waves will have some wavelength. So the wave which will have a small wavelength, very small wavelength, these are called microwave. So don't confuse with the word micro. Micro doesn't stand here, that is 10^-6. So the wavelength is not 10^-6, but the range of microwave is, the wavelength is from 10 cm to 1 mm is the range of microwave. So microwave stands for very small wave. So the frequency range from 1 GHz to 300 GHz is called microwave band, whose corresponding wavelength is from 10 cm to 1 mm, and beyond this 1 mm band there is a millimeter wave band. So this is the frequency band, or you can say this is the spectrum. You can see the lower frequency which can be used for radar, this FM, AM and all this thing. Then the S frequency will rise, the wavelength will start decreasing. As the frequency is larger, wavelength will be small. So the range 3×10^8 to 3×10^11 is called microwave range. So various so smaller wavelength, we are having application like FM, TV, FM, AM, TV. Then as frequency will increase to microwave, we are having various other applications. Then we are having infrared, then visible light, ultraviolet, X-ray, gamma. The frequency is increasing as well as its properties are changing. The visible spectrum is from 700 nanometer to 400 nanometer. And beyond the visible, there will be an ultraviolet region and infrared region. Now, various bands are designated in a microwave frequency. These are also called as the radar band. So, this band, so these frequencies are depicted here. So, we'll start from L band, because earlier band like medium frequencies from 300 kHz to 3 MHz, high frequencies from 3 MHz to 30 MHz. UHF is from 300 MHz to 3 GHz. Now this L band to F band are designated as radar band. So L band is from 1 to 2 GHz. Thereafter we are in the S band, that is from 2 to 4 GHz. Then C band, this is used largely for a communication purpose in a satellite communication, that will be from 4 to 8 GHz. Then X band, that will be from 8 to 12 GHz. All the equipment in the laboratories are in X band, because at 8 to 12 GHz wavelength is small, so the component corresponds to this wavelength will be small. So all the equipment in our laboratory are in this band, X band. Then KU band, that is 12 to 18 GHz. Here U stands for upper to K, that will be KU, that will be 12 to 18 GHz. Then K band is from 18 to 26 GHz. KA, that is above K band, that is KA band, that is 26 to 40 GHz, and so on. These bands are designated. Each bands are having at different applications. So depending upon applications, we can allotted. So this band are allotted because these are the standard frequency designated to this band. So whatever the component you will take from, you take from anywhere, it will have a standard size and shape. That's why the standardization has been done. So typical frequencies and its use are given here. So most of microwave we are using starting from 1 gigahertz to, or you can say yes, 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. So in nowadays we are also using mobile communication on mobile phone. This is also will falls in the microwave region. Then we are having a GPS, microwave oven, USDBS, USISM, and so on and so forth. Many applications are there. We'll see one by one. Next is, what will happen if frequency will increase? Let us take, we'll have some small board or the circuit which is working at a low frequency. Can this circuit can work at a high frequency? So let us see some. There will be a sine wave at a low frequency. So let us take the frequency is 50 hertz. So corresponding lambda, it will be equal to C by F is 3 into 10 raised to 8 divided by 50, that is 50 hertz. So that will comes around a 6000 kilometer. So the wavelength corresponding to 50 hertz is 6000 kilometer. Now let us take, we are having a circuit board which is roughly equal to 10 centimeter or 15 centimeter. Now if we are having a sine wave, let us take this frequency is 50 hertz and this is one wavelength. So if we will take a sample from two nearby point, let us take t is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2 at low frequency. So this nearby point will have a very small change in amplitude as well as very small change in phase. By comparing with the wavelength, that is 6000 kilometer, and this will be very 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 small. So the amplitude change or phase change will be very small at low frequency. But if we go at higher frequency, what will happen? So at higher frequency, let us take at the same point T1 and T2, we are taking a sample. So you can see the amplitude here, it will be negative maximum and there will be a zero at T is equal to T2. So there will be very large change in phase as well as amplitude, and this is because of high frequency. Now so the component which we have designed, we will not be useful at higher frequency. It can be used at low frequency only, where there will be very less amplitude and phase change. But at high frequency, there will be very large frequency and phase and amplitude change. So we cannot use that same component or same circuit for at large higher frequency. So let us consider I am having a 1 gigahertz and the corresponding wavelength will be 30 cm. At 10 gigahertz, the wavelength will be 3 cm. So higher the frequency, there will be very there will be a very large problem. As well as this, as the frequency will increase, the amplitude will decrease, or you can say there will be a large attenuation because of skin wave effect. So because of this, amplitude and phase are not are changing very rapidly, we cannot use standard circuit theory like what you have seen or what you have studied in earlier the third or fourth semester. That will be circuit and network theory. You have solved some circuit and you have found out current and voltage by using Kirchhoff voltage law and current law. But since phase and amplitude are changing very we cannot apply this Kirchhoff voltage and current law in the microwave circuit or microwave theory. So how we can what will be the solution of this problem? We want to find out voltage and current, but we cannot apply Kirchhoff voltage law and current law. So how can we can find out the current and voltage from the microwave circuit? So the solution is, we'll use a more fundamental quantity than voltage and current. The fundamental quantities are the field quantity, like electric field, magnetic field, and this kind of quantities are more fundamental quantities. So we'll use the Maxwell equation. We are having this field quantity and we'll use Maxwell's equation to find out the solution of this problem. Now the component which you can touch and the circuit you are touching, that will be having, that is made up of a lump pot or lump equipment or a lump element which you can touch and which you can measure using a micrometer or microwave. Now the component in a microwave are called distributed element. The value of each and at each and every point will be different. So this component or this element are distributed throughout the length of the microwave circuit. So the phase and voltage of current changes significantly over the physical extents of the device. We'll see, we'll elaborate more this topic in our next lecture, that is transmission line. Now we'll see the advantage and disadvantage of microwave communication. So what are the, as we have seen that the microwave is the region from 1 GHz to 300 GHz. So it will have some certain advantages. What are these advantages? We'll see one by one. So first one is increased bandwidth availability, then increased directivity, fading effect and reliability. We'll see one by one. The power requirement will be low, then transparency property of microwave. So we'll start with increased bandwidth availability. Many low frequency, so there are many applications like a telegraphic speech, music and video signals. So this requires some bandwidth, like telegraph channel will require bandwidth of 120 Hz, while speech will require bandwidth of 2 to 3 kHz. Music channel require bandwidth 10 to 20 kHz, while a TV channel require bandwidth of 7 MHz. Now this low frequency band is crowded with this kind of application, so the natural solution is we'll go for higher frequency. So we can modulate we'll multiplex all this channel and we'll modulate over to higher frequency signal. So this signal will be modulated at high frequency, or you can say at the microwave frequency, where the bandwidth is quite large. Let us understand in other way. Let us take the more frequency, higher the frequency, it will be more bandwidth. Like more bandwidth can be realized at the higher frequency. Let us take example, a 1% bandwidth of 600 MHz is 6 MHz, which can provide a data rate of 6 Mbps. While at 60 GHz, this is the frequency which we are going to use in 5G and 6G. So 60 GHz, 1% bandwidth is 600 MHz, which will give us the data rate of 600 Mbps. So higher the frequency, more will be the bandwidth. So since we are using 1 to 300 GHz, so the bandwidth will be very large compared to the low frequency signal. The next is increased directivity or increased gain. Now the directivity is given by 4πAE/λ², where A is effective aperture. So directivity is directly proportional to this can be written as 4πAF² / C², where lambda is equal to F by C we have used. So directivity is directly proportional to square of the frequency. So larger the frequency, more will be the directivity. So antenna gain, now directivity and gain are related. Directivity or gain is equal to efficiency times directivity. So gain and directivity are proportional. Now antenna gain is proportional, or you can say directivity is proportional to electrical size of antenna, as well as it is proportional to square of frequency. So at the higher frequency, more antenna gain can be obtained. So if we are having a, let us take the effective aperture is common, like this shown here. If you use at a lower frequency, it will give us less directivity, or it will give us less gain. At the same time, if we use for higher frequency, at microwave frequency, this will give us larger gain, or you can say larger directivity. Now frequency reuse. So you are already know the various kinds of communication mechanism. So we are using for short wave or a for a ground wave propagation, sky wave propagation, and so we are using ionosphere for sky wave propagation. So we are using various layer of ionosphere. So this will introduce the signal, will goes to the ionosphere and it will bend and it will reverse back to earth, while this will be the line of sight or ground wave communication. So microwave signal travel by line of sight. It will always travel by line of sight. It can be not obstructed by ionosphere. It will always travel with line of sight. So it cannot be banned by ionosphere at low, like in a lower frequency signal. So if you want to communicate with the satellite, so we have to use microwave signal. So this is what depicted here. So satellite and terrestrial communication links with very high capacity are therefore possible with frequency. So this is the line of sight communication we are using here. We are using only line of sight. So the same frequency can be used by somewhere else in Earth for line of sight propagation. So we can use this frequency we use because of this line of sight. Next is fading effect and reliability. So we have seen here that if we'll send a signal at a low frequency signal, it is from 30 to 40 megahertz, that signal will be banned and that will be received back to the Earth. So as well as at low frequency, there will be a multi-path propagation. So signal will travel line of sight as well as it will travel to different location. It will be reflected back and it will be received at the receiver. So we are having a very many copies of the signal which are time phased or which are delayed by time, and the algebraic sum of all the signals will take place at the receiver. So we will get a fading because of this multipath propagation. So the signal, whatever the signal will be there or whatever the pulse will be there, it will broaden. Because of broadening, there will be inter-signal interference, ISI. Now this is because of multipath propagation. Since microwave is microwave, only at microwave frequency there will be less fading or there will be no fading because it will be only line of sight propagation. So there will be no fading, so signal reliability is very large. As frequency increases, the reception becomes clearer and clearer in the microwave frequency range. Next is power requirement. So we have seen that at the microwave frequency, the power requirement of transmitter at microwave frequency, the wavelength is very small, so the size of equipment will be very small. So smaller the equipment, less power will be required. As well as for the antenna purpose, we have seen that as the frequency increases, the gain will be increases. So as gain increases, it means we have to give smaller power to the antenna for transmission of its signal. But the disadvantage is, we have to use more number of repeater stations for microwave link. Next is applications of a microwave. There are many applications like telecommunication, radar, then commercial application, industrial application, and war. There are many applications. So we'll see one by one. First one is a telecommunication, or we are using this for broadcasting. Nowadays we are using a DTH. So like Airtel DTH, then DTH, then many DTH are there. All these are working, these are the satellite TV broadcasting which are working at 12 GHz. We have one that will be in 12 GHz. So we are using the microwave region for TV broadcasting, satellite TV broadcasting. Next is communication. Now because of increased bandwidth, we have seen earlier, because of increased bandwidth for communication, the higher carrier frequency, all the signals at lower frequency are multiplex and that will be modulated at higher frequency, and that will be transmitted by a microwave communication link. A microwave link is point-to-point link using the propagation of electromagnetic wave at microwave frequency through free space. Now, the very prominent application is in microwave heating. So the microwave heating takes place by vibrating the molecules of the atom. So if there are a water molecule, so mainly it will heat the rate of microwave. So whatever the thing you need to heat, you apply microwave signal. Now because of application of microwave signal, the molecule inside that material, there will be some water content. So water will be H2O. So this microwave alternating signal will so this water molecule tries to align with the microwave signal. So one time in the positive half cycle it will be in upper side, and in the negative half cycle it will be in lower side. So let us take at the in the oven we are using 2.4 gigahertz, so we are vibrating the water molecule by 2.4 crore times per second. So this will produce a friction, and because of this friction it will produce a heat. So the rate of microwave power absorption in most material is proportional to the water content. So larger the water, more will be the heat. So this property is used for microwave heating, because the microwave signal penetrate most non-conductor. Microwave power provide a most efficient means of applying heat uniformly throughout the body. Microwave heating is used in many process industries for heating, drying and sterilizing. In microwave heating, heat is generated inside the material is being heated. The microwave heating is totally different than a conventional heating. What is happening in the conventional heating is, the heat is first transferred to the surface of a material either by conduction or convection. While here in a microwave heating, the heat is generated directly inside material because of the friction of the molecule. Therefore, the faster temperature rise can be obtained. Same principle is used in a microwave oven. We are having some food. We are using a magnetron as a power source here, so which will provide a microwave power to the this channel. So microwave oven is electronically controlled home appliance used for cooking. It uses the principle of dielectric heating at microwave frequency. So the microwave signal generated from the magnetron will goes to this channel multimode cavity, and the food will be stirred, and it will produce, it will take a the molecule will be try to align, and it will produce a friction and it will heat internally. The next application is thickness measurement of metals. So for the thickness measurement, we are using reflection coefficient measurement technique. So we are using circulator. This is used as a duplexer. So this is the circulator. Then we are using phase shifter. Two wands are aligned. Three-port circulator. The property of circulator is it will allow the power transfer from one port to its next port only in a clockwise direction. So let us take, we are providing power to port C, then only power is available at port B. If you are having power at port B, then it will be only transfer power to port A and so on. So only circularly it will provide power to only to next port, not to any other port. So the reflection coefficient measurement technique is used. Now the metal sheet whose thickness we want to measure is placed between these two holes. Now these are placed such a way that port A and port B are connected to the waveguide hole. Port C is connected to the reflection. This port C is connected to the reflection measurement circuit. Now a resonant cavity is formed along the length of pipe. Now let us take this. Now this is in a resonant, and we are placing some metal sheet. So power is given to one of the port. This power is, let us take, power is given to port A. So power is will be there, but there because of placement of this sheet, now there will be no or but less power available here. Because of this, and the signal will be transmitted here, as well as the signal, the received signal from here is phase shifted and given to this. This signal will come to reflection measurement circuit. So it will take a difference between these two and find out the relative thickness of the sheet. So these are some of the applications of microwave. We have seen some advantage, disadvantage. The main disadvantage of microwave is it will produce heat. We have nowadays there are very concerned, like we are using mobile phone which will produce radiation, and because of this, if we'll place our phone like this, most of our water content will be in our head, so it will produce heat in our nearby ear, and it will produce heat in our head, so it will lead to cancer. So we'll see this later. But these are the some of the applications, advantage and disadvantage of microwaves. So in the next lecture we will see the transmission line and its solution. So in this lecture what we have seen is we have seen what is actually microwave, we have seen the electromagnetic spectrum, we have seen various advantages, various disadvantages and the applications of microwave. Thank you very much.